When winter wren and buried thrush break into April voices, and elderberry branches crack and thrust, and Sitka spruce and caws of crow and wild waves all slap the ocean shore, this small black beetle jaws a crumb, and smaller scarlet mite roves over needle dirt to somewhere we will never see, as sword fern rots upon its ancient mound and fiddleheads unfurl. When sorrel triplets burst upon the guileless scene, and moss on branches point away through trackless wood. Puma sinks its teeth in throat of deer who gives its life unwillingly but has no choice. When somewhere on the other side of time and whirling world, beside some withered waterhole, a warthog coughs. Baboon flashes scarlet rump and grimace, blue and toothy at the other males, at swollen, gravid female, at lioness who charges, then withdraws behind the yellow grass. Then polar bears on permafrost and skuas over tundra sedge will take whatever sustenance the day affords, then sleep and sleep and sleep some more despite the midnight sun. As in the forest gloom, the lichen hangs and sways above the snaily stream, and mushrooms crowd the mossy bank where hemlocks screen the sunlight. The silage of the slugs and slime, of molds and thyme, where water bears and woodlice roam. Bacteria and nematodes make way among the great and fleshy entrails of the world. And what about the turquoise-mantled giant clam, cemented in the coral reef beneath Antipodean skies? The urchins dragging spines across the limy bottoms, poking holes in water bags to make the ocean new for every life on every tide. Or clouds that drop their shadows on the desert floor, that parking lot for tortoises, where cactus reaches out for gods it never knew or needed. Flash floods scrape away whatever luck the horned toad ever had, which isn't much, it seems, until you think of otter clamped in Orca's Gape, or flank of desert oryx running red beneath the claws of leopard, every desiccated leaf and flower folded in upon itself, until you think of ants and worms and voles and frogs in tractor ruts, or salmon smolts in heron's bill, until you think of this great ape, the one that stands upright and poses every question ever asked, in such a world where everything that grows breaks down, and down, and down, then grows, and grows, and grows, and grows again.